You speak and my heart finds a rest. No other place, no other love but yours. I've tried everything. Nothing could satisfy the loneliness and emptiness. Just would not leave.
Thank you very much. We're here again tonight. I've brought you somebody that you have expecting to see to all the time, somebody who does not disappear from the face of the radio, from the face of newspaper. In fact, it's a name that does not need any introduction. When you hear his voice, you definitely know who it is. I'm talking today about Mr. Magic Ulinda Sibiya. And today, obviously, it's going to be very interesting to know what Mr. Magic Ilvela. We are sitting with a man, a legend, yeah, radio, Ulinda Sibiya. Today, at home, Gifuna Sihlale Phansi Sixoxe noLinda Sibiya. Today, he's on the other seat. I am sitting here. I call this one a hot seat because I ask questions.
It's hot.
I ask questions that other people will not ask. Linda Sibiya, tell us more about yourself. You are born from Meshowe, Zalo Mama Mvulane, Ubaba Ugidangaye.
Yes, Ugidangaye. And I wanted to become a radio DJ when I was very young. Then I moved up to Durban to stay with my father. My father was a security guard in Ati Baba. And then when I was here in Durban, Timothy, like higher, every after school, and then you sell apples.
Okay, so you are not only Umsagasi, you came to Durban and Waba Umtaisoma Apple.
Yes, after school, Ganestimalian. I took up, wearing a uniform.
Yeah.
Then later, you know, you go back home. And then you count the money around 9 o'clock at night. Then at school, at Ndomale High School, they thought I figure A school in it. Then I became a head prefect and then a class prefect. And you know, it's because I wanted to do my homework.
Wow.
What's it?
So you came home. Wanga was when the homework.
Then I sleep and then I'm tired.
Kaya,
Yes,
so you have to wait.
And then in the same house, we're selling beers.
Okay, abantu
bayazi. You must wait for them. All right. 2 o'clock.
Good back to Taisa. Then you can be able to sleep.
Who will you run and say, "Me,
then the following morning, you have to wake up. Linda Sibiya and be in the trains. What is going on? You know, when somebody is growing under difficult conditions, Linda Sibiya, especially in this generation, as equal sound, just tell us what was going on in your mind. Bishop, are you creating any future? Are you saying anything that has to do with your future?
Bishop, if I look back, God was busy training my voice to become a better radio DJ.
Okay, all right.
God was busy. By that time, I was looking at poverty. Okay. I might end up selling apples in the train. But my father, Ubaba, never had an idea that you must go to the university, to college. No, there was nothing. My father was excited that, no, this boy, I wish I got him. And then he goes to school. My dad was very happy. After matric, and then I went to Ubaba, and no, I want to become a teacher because to become a radio personality, you must be a teacher. Okay. Ubaba, I don't have money. What I have money to take you to a security school, go we'll train over a security. Then I was trained as a security guard. I came back after 3 weeks.
Okay.
Ojibaba, very good. Nice one. Please, look for work. When become a security guard. You must go and work and look after your mother.
But at that time, when you go and train to be a security guard, you said, Linda Sibiya, in your mind, there was a radio.
In my mind, even there at the security, I would have a radio at Kansas City, listen to Kansas City, and Bolos and Zimande, Manda Malaguan, and one day, I'm going to be behind the microphone. I was highly, highly motivated. If I'm off, I'll go to Cozy FM and then wait there and watch what Kansas City doing his show, 3 to 6. Then I'll go home. Meet wow.
So did you work with Kansas City?
I worked with him, yeah. When I joined Cozy in 1996, Kansas City was there. I remember I received the call from Cozy, Babu Zulu. He was the acting station manager. Because I wanted to kill myself that year, 1996. I was at the bridge La Epiria in Durban, and I said, no, before I jump, let me just go and call the SAPC. Then I called. But I said, no, we've been waiting for you. You remember the time there were no cell phones?
Yes, yeah, yeah.
And I was calling with the last 30 cents. But no, come to SAPC tomorrow. But no, I'm coming now. I can run from Peria to SAPC. But oh, Baba, I'll wait for you, Baba.
So why were they waiting for you? You had already applied.
Yeah.
We have already been there to tell them what you want to be.
Because when I was 1995, I joined Radio Maritzburg.
Okay.
And then I did 1 hour demo to SAPC. Normally, you don't do 1 hour. You do 10 minutes. But my demo was 1 hour. And I knew that they have to listen to my 1 hour. Wow. And then when I got there in 1996, Babu Zuluwatu, we listened to your demo. We've been looking for you. Mm-hmm. We've tried even to announce on Radio Guti, wow. Lindo, Guti Sibiya, please come to Kozi FM. Can you start tomorrow with Manta Malagwani?
Wow.
I said, no. I remember that I had one jean and one shirt. It was everyday thing. And I told him, yes, I can come tomorrow. I remember I went back to Mlaz, where I was growing up, Baba Utibo, that Malume, no, I've got him savings. Was it Yahoo? Not in the SAPC. Was it all? Was it by Security Lab?
Obviously, Linda, you were trained to be a security, and everybody was expecting you to be a security.
To be a security?
Yeah.
Not, no, I'll be a radio announcer. Tomorrow I'm starting Amanda Managwan. What no? For what? Not no, we'll see, we'll listen. But I'm here, uting bolegama pulugai too, from whom to same size, ne shirt and mutaya bang nigeza. Ukozi bati angfige on the following day at 11. But I was there at 8 o'clock in the morning.
Wow.
Waiting.
Wow.
For my time.
Wow.
And then but you know, why are you early? But no, maybe you change. So I'm here. I'm ready to start.
Wow.
Then I started with Manta Malagwana in 1996, between 12 and 3. Until they gave me my show between 12 to 5 in the morning,
right.
every Saturday.
Right, 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 right. Linda, jumping the time where you had your own show, you had so much following, you have so much people who believed in you.
Yes.
What would you say? Because, I mean, when you mention the name of Linda Sibiya, even a child out there, I mean, it's like mentioning the name of Kansas City.
Yes.
Every person of my age would know who I'm speaking about.
Yes. Bishop, Bengenza show ukuthi makuthiwa ngingena ngo 3 to 6 ukhozi but bekufika ngo 1 o'clock. Sometimes ngifika ngo 10, so I prepare myself. God u Kansas City no Cool Cat Gumbi ibona lento niyibonayo u Cool Cat no Kansas.
Wow.
U Cool Cat wangifundisa i desk.
Okay.
U Kansas wangifundisa ukuthi how to become a brand, ube yi brand, the brand.
Right.
He said to me, you must respect time and you must respect people. What abantu by business.
Okay.
Once you respect them and then you love them. Same people will love you.
Wow.
And that's what happened to me.
Wow.
And ngahluka, and then what's it to give me? The voice that you have, akekho umuntu onayo la ku Khozi. And awufani no Kansas. Ngenzeli into eyi-one ngelindayo. Creator is space uma ungekho on air. Ungabikho muntu ozofila igap. And then I did that.
Now it looks like the space that you created is a space that is working for you even outside in the world.
Yeah, sure.
Because, well, honestly, as you are listening, I don't think at this moment there is somebody ofike wangena khaxa, especially okhozini wafana no Linda Sibiya. I'm not saying that so that we create a pride, but
sure.
I'm saying that because kunezinto uLinda Sibiya athi uzifunde kubantu. Afike asebenza
nabo.
I think that is the element that is very important to me ukuthi when God gives you an opportunity, what do you learn in that particular opportunity that uNkulunkulu akunikeza yona. Now Linda, I'm sure ukuthi when you were working emsakazweni, it was not like nice all the time. There has been ups and downs in life. How did you manage ukuthi kungabi khona isikhathi la abantu abakulalele bezokuza ukuthi hayi angathi uLinda Sibiya namhlanje ushayekile? And what is your experience ukushayeka empilweni? How did you manage? Because you are still young. Even now you are still young. You still have a future. You are still going to talk to me about what is the next phase kaLinda Sibiya.
Sure.
Because uLinda Sibiya is growing with phases.
Yes, for sure.
What has made you strong in isikhathi usebenza okhosini?
I think one Ukansa City said to me, if you're on front page, negative or positive,
right,
you must know everyone is listening that day.
Okay.
So once you're on front page and then you go to parliament as a member of parliament, make sure everyone that day they're expecting Uti Umuyaz Bishop is not gonna say anything.
Okay.
That day you must be on your top form. You must be number one.
Wow.
So if Ilanga newspaper or Isoweten or Isolezo or Noma City Press, I'm on front page. One Kansas City, what give me? Abandu Aba understand Abazu Tennis. So when you're on air, do your work. Don't answer to anything that is on the paper.
Okay.
So the same energy Buna is on.
Okay.
Give them. It must be times seven. Uh-huh. So when I'm driving through cars and then I see placards and then Linda Sbia in hot water again, Linda Sbia hot water, Linda Sbia in hot water. The one thing that I have, the listeners of Focus FM, they must
be waiting.
They're expecting. So I have to be hot times seven.
Okay.
Not in hot water, yep.
Okay. So in life, Linda, you have learned to excel.
Yes.
I'm saying these things because one day we're expecting to read about them in the newspaper. Kuthi uLindo survive kanjani?
Yes, Bishop.
uLinda yini emenze kwa namakhona la kade sithi hayi uLinda akabuyi khona.
Sure.
uLinda wabonakala esebuye.
Yes, Bishop.
What keeps you going? Yini le engaphakathi kwena ekunika lolu fuqufuqu lokuthi I am not going to give up.
There's a white guy, man, who trained me in 1994, 1995. He is a former YB intelligence. He gave me a book, Sun Tzu, The Art of War.
Okay.
Even now in my car, wherever I go, I read that book. He said to me, every day you must check your enemy, Wuti Yagi Pisaid.
Okay.
And number two, what you have to do, don't attack your enemy when they're strong. Avoid them. Run away from them.
All right.
When they're weak, attack them.
Okay.
And try your best. Good. When they think you are far, you are next to them.
Wow.
When they think you're next to them, you are far away from them.
Wow.
So
wow.
So what helped me, Ubuti, I understood, okay, 2014, when SABC read a letter, okay, they called me on the 29th, but he explained to the SABC why my finances gosh.
Okay. All right.
And I said, okay, let me go to my attorney so they can write a letter to you. Mm-hmm. But I don't know, you're making a mistake.
Yeah.
And then I left the SABC. I left the building. I went to an attorney. I said, no, definitely, I heard in 2013 there was a plot against me. This is the time. Mm-hmm. They are taking me out.
Okay.
But in the letter that I'm going to write to them, it must be a letter as a fact to ban. That letter, if you're asking, he published it in a cozy commotion.
So before you even go there, you are saying to me, empilweni, when you are doing well, and people are seeing you are doing well, somewhere behind, downfall.
Bishop, they're there. Always. They are blocking you.
All right.
It started in 2004 when I was on the peak.
Okay.
When I was on TV and radio.
Right.
And I remember my boss, even I called him my boss now, Upoloza. Wang B is what resigned. Don't be full time. I want you to make money. You are making money. And he said to me, you want to go to a university, go funda, no college, no more funda, in Kaban. Got him from Kalingaban, a business in major communications. So Upoloza saw what he called me, I can see enemies, I can see people.
Mm.
You are becoming a problem. Mm. Even the whole SAPC. Bishop, 2004, I was voted number 20 with. I was there. There was no radio personality.
Yes.
That was the only one.
Yes, I remember.
Can you imagine, Buti, that information got to within the management? I mustn't be told because things were big. And they told me, what? No. Why be on jail, Buti, when Mandela is number one, no Winnie, no Thabo Mbeki, and everyone, and then you are number 20, you are the only radio personality.
Mm.
After you, Wawukona, or Dr. Kumalo, what? Already the war was there.
Okay.
So I had to resign, give it on contract. I'm on television, and then there's Coca-Cola. Coca-Cola is, I'm a brand ambassador. There was a lot of enemies. People, they see you, Bishop, on the pulpit, see you in parliament.
Right.
Abayazi fight on Nayo.
That's a part. That's a very important part where people have got to know, Wuti, as much as you grow, umunkulunkulu ekubeka kwi podium, la uzobona khona, even your enemies.
Sure.
Are coming up,
but they don't play
in a very strong
time
way.
Seven, because I started even in Magic Tour. Magic Tour was bringing money. The house that I have, it was Magic Tour. The apartments that I bought in KZN, it was Magic Tour. Really, really, Bishop, if I didn't have Magic communications and also the magic talk, there will be no Linda Sibiya. I tell you, I'll be on the street.
Now, Linda, why are people calling you Mr. Magic? Where does that come from?
It comes from Kansas City, Kulketko. Okay. We were playing at the SAPC at the back, and Kulket was doing magic. And then he said, where is the money? He had 1 rand. He put the money here, but the money was in his pocket. Okay. There's nothing.
Okay.
But Mr. Magic. Mr. Magic. What do Kansas City? Voice from magic, you know. And then Kansas wasn't getting more in. What? 4:10, Linda, be on Mr. Magic, who's Bella? And then the listeners, they called me Mr. Magic.
Wow. Wow.
Then Kansas City from there. Gang into man in the program, he would call me at 5 to 5 every morning.
Okay.
Hi, Linda, why shy? What la lela? Who also by king ala? He blessed me.
Mm-hmm.
He anointed me.
Mm-hmm.
He says,
wow.
Can you imagine when David was anointed, but he went back? He was anointed but not appointed.
Mm-hmm.
I was anointed but not appointed.
Mm-hmm.
When it was my time to be appointed, again, 3 to 6, is where you attract enemies as well.
Wow.
You can be a bishop in the church, AECC, but once you get the appointment by a member of parliament, one of my enemies, Abuya times 7.
Okay.
It happened to me, Bishop.
Okay, all right. Now, Linda, you are speaking once more about Kansas City being your mentor. Being your mentor. But I've learned also that in your life, you've got that element of mentorship. You want to see something in young people. That is why I saw you doing the tours that you are doing in universities.
Yes,
I want you to talk to them, Uti. Why is it? What did you want to instill kubantu abasha? Because I believe Uti akekho omunye umuntu oseke wayenza magic tour. I remember at one point when we started, that was the first time I met Kelly Kumalo.
Yes.
For the first time I met Kelly Kumalo, it was at DUT, I think, and you were doing your magic tour.
Yes, for sure.
What inspired you to do a thing like magic tour?
Yeah, I went to Boloza, I'm on top right now. But now I don't want to stay in the studio and do my shows in the studio.
Yes.
I want to go out to the students. I want to meet the youth. Because mangi is in Twembera, Zimnander, Umnander, Umsunger, Linder, Lisbier, by Tandaland. Let me go and meet them. We went out. Big Nas, born out of the magic tour.
Yeah.
El Vovo Tirango, out of the magic tour. Was expanding out of the magic tour. This boy now, Uchubuchubu, is doing Yachola 99. Out of the magic tour, he came. And then Kelly Kumalo, all of them.
Yes.
I gave them an opportunity, the platform to say, guys, I'm here now. I want to see the youth. Let's go and meet the youth. Tears of this world. We went with them to Umangosu, to DJ Masiyes from the magic tour. Ika Malgas Kameza, it was created. We pushed. Kameza, he was my content and then technical producer.
I remember.
Ngambiza Kameza. Umrosa Limari, Limararara, Limarororo. I gave them platforms because I believed, dude, if God can bless you and that beg a pezu, give a man the opportunity. Be on top and say, guys, come. Let's come. Come here. What's a Kelly Kumalo? Come here. Chup, what's a la? Tira, come here. Big nuts. And then look at them today through the magic tour. It worked. It was a magic tour edutainment. And Boloza said to me, this thing is big.
Mm-hmm.
Are you making money out of this thing? I said, no. You must make money. Go to government and government, they come on board.
Okay.
I won't lie to you. Ndosi came on board and other departments, they came on board. Then Sakuwa Shumele Evangeli.
So you are saying it very well, Uti, Washumele Evangeli. Kuna lili Evangeli, Obul Shumela Kubandabasha, Abasema Universities, Abasema Universities,
yes,
with the magic tour. Yini nobufunugia kagla bandabasha, Abasema Universities.
Your parents magnegas the opportunity to Linda Sibiya and I was open, I was transparent. To good.
Yes.
No, I've never been to university. It's the first time I'm here. Please don't drop out. Number two, drugs, I seven this too. And it was nice, you remember the abstinence walk that you started.
Yes.
It helped because when you were on stage, I had that thing, oh, we used to walk. So if I say to them, valala uvulela, and then they'll laugh.
Understand. Yes.
So the language that you speak to the youth, I have four boys. The way I speak in my car, we play hip hop with them. I understand where they think, where they go. So going to the university and give them motivation, it was good. And then the element of entertainment, there's kwaito, there's hip-hop, there's a DJ, and then Bishop comes on stage, who's Dube, and then you don't preach.
Yeah.
You speak to them with love.
Mm.
You, You came to give them. Other pastors came, but you were there forefront to say, Bandabash, I love you. Come to ECC. And then in this same church, DJs were playing music, and then you were criticized to go to Uli and the Sphere, not to where what they're doing, they're bringing. No, it was the concept come be sure. And it worked. The youth, but no, if I'm in Durban, let me go to ECC, because you are not telling Bandabash, but you speak to them with love and say, hey, I've never been to university. Respect to parents.
Yeah.
And then someone was crying in Joburg. It why? What no? You came to AUKZN. Today I'm a doctor because of you.
Wow.
I was in drugs, but I chose with no. So it worked.
You see, I do want to say to you at home, there is a vacuum. I will speak about that maybe later on or at other given time. When you go to universities at this time, let us say there was no COVID-19. If you go to universities, there is a big vacuum.
I'm telling you, Bishop.
When we went there to DUT, to Mangosuthu,
University of
Zululand, you will find the stadium being full of young people. And they are full. And for me, what was more shocking, one night at DOT, I think it was about 2 o'clock in the morning, and the young people were still there.
Sure.
They were still enjoying themselves,
yes.
And
yes.
There was order. There were,
yes.
From those incidents, I've never heard of any young person being stabbed, young person being raped, or
yes.
You know, which are the elements that are happening in the universities today. Now, do you think when this program is not supported, you are being failed? In your initiative of wanting to bring something to the young people?
I'm being failed, Kakul Bishop. But this year, I must say, the MEC of Health, Unomaku, I met with the HOD, with the management. What, guys, I want to go to universities and TVET colleges.
Right.
When we finish, let's go to municipalities. And then COVID started, and then we went back, no, Linda, we cannot do anything.
Okay.
But we want to support this thing. So if they don't support it, it's killing. Because my vision, E.T., if we continue with the magic tour, we want to go to Metro FM and get an ambassador, Cozy FM ambassador, Mhlobene an ambassador. So we go to all provinces. I went to Mpumalanga, the premier in Mpumalanga, which is here. Please come. We want this thing. We want to do it. Bloemfontein, same thing. And then COVID started. So but before, I would say 2010 and 11, I was failed because that was a peak time to go to universities and speak to the youth.
But Linda Sbia, do you think you still have a major or important role in this present generation? Do you have anything to teach the young people? Do you think Linda Sbia must be supported, must stand up, even after COVID? Linda Sbia, that's my interest, because I love young people. You can introduce Linda Sbia,
On my birthday, on the day of Matiba, later when we had the fun run, we were not many, but the guys, I met the journalists from Milan, and I said, but they said, let's have a fun run. And then now in August, they are planning to have a gender-based violence walk. I want to walk with celebrities.
Okay.
I want 100 men to walk with them to say, against Abandu Abesfazane, Tineza Madod, on behalf of Madod and Lupayo, we are here.
Okay.
I'm giving away the mobile classroom Mandeni with Umgeni Water. Umgeni Water is working with me.
Okay.
Where I'm building a skill center Mshwati, 18 million with Umgeni Water.
Wow.
We're going to Umdoni, and then there's money for Umdoni as well. So I'm on the ground. People, they might not even hear and see on television. I'm on the ground. I'm a soldier. The magic tour, if the COVID repeller, I'm coming back. The new TV show is coming. It is not over with Mr. Magic. We are busy. Now we could recording on May. Now we are waiting. In September, but we might go and record.
Okay.
The new show that is coming, the big one. It's gonna be controversial. I'm interviewing people like Omalema in that show. Baningi, even all political parties, I'll interview them. It is not over. Guti, you are a political member or you are a politician. Do you believe in God? And then I go to your staff where people, they don't go to that stuff. And I'm here to show the world to Usbia, I can confront anyone and ask anyone any question.
But what is very interesting is the question that I wanted to ask you, Usbia, about your walk of faith. You know, because when you encounter the things that you have encountered, in your life, inkinga obena so laudule kona, you know, your popular person umthanda uTD Jakes, of which you had an experience where you went to America and
yes,
in TD Jakes check. He says, I would never follow a person who has never failed in life.
Aye, come on.
And I've seen you living with those words, Uguti, I'm not going to allow anybody to fail me. I call it a stance and a walk of faith.
Come on.
And how has it helped you, ukuba ne faith, and how has it anchored you empilweni ukuthi ulinda sibiya utshela abantu ukuthi iminto engimisile iyenze ukuthi ngikwazi ukuma, it's faith. What can you say about your faith?
Bishop, radical faith, all the way, radical faith. You must have faith. 2014, SAPC, your contract has been terminated.
Right.
It was Jan 30, quarter to 5. I walk out from the studio, I called one person, my mother. I said, SAPC in Koshile, but who cares in Ogulda, I was taller. And then I went, I called my kids, Munya, I said, boarding school. I said, tomorrow you read the paper, I'll be on social media, I wanna come and see you. I went to see my son and I said to him, listen, I'm no more working for SAPC, but let me tell you something. Look, Adela Crawford, and then all of them, I called my kids and I told them. And then from there, I took, and then the following morning, Bishop, this is Mfuke Labandu, nge radical faith.
Yes, yes.
The following morning, Bishop Mbuyazi, ngang ngiya Mzansi Magic to sign a contract, Gasfunwas.
Okay.
I remember ngene panoin. My father used to say something very powerful. Waiti mtanami, umaz neta oba mkile kaku.
All right.
Half paga tripisi yam ngene panoin.
Okay.
Oba I knew that I'm on front pages.
So ngala, iminyango ivaleki iphoshiwe.
But ngithi nakhona ngisebanoweni ngihamba
okay.
Nefaith.
You know, okay.
Bishop, abazalwane, and if you believe in God, and whoever out there, if you believe in God, there are moments where you are weak. You don't even want to pray.
Okay.
There was no prayer. Yeah. There was nothing. I walked in there. You know, when I walked from Emodwini walking airport, my mama was one morning, as if on the paper, she dropped down umshanelo, wakala, my baba, wamemeza. So already the baba ngenza ngibe weak.
Yeah,
I'm going through the checker in, I'm weak already.
Yeah, yeah.
But mangena ngaphakathi, there was MEC, the former MEC, ubaba wa help.
Usibongiseni
Dlomo.
Yes.
Wathi yini manje ngifunda la? Benza laba bantu. Ngano no was right. Wathi man, be strong men daughter, man, be strong leader.
Mm.
And then I sat there, I was weak. Bishop, I was weak. I landed in Joburg, then bank drivers to Mzansi Magic. When we got the meeting in, Abelungu, sometimes you can see Abu Soba.
Yes.
They're not okay.
Okay.
And then I sat down. I said, before we start the meeting, if we sign, we have to sign the contract. I think you had the news. But yes. We had the news. But yeah, I'm no more working for Ukhozi. If you wanted me as a brand of Ukhozi, I'm so sorry. I'm not going to do the show anymore. You must find someone.
Mm.
But give us 5 minutes.
Okay.
They left the boardroom. And then I remember this that melody came back. I said, so it means as you know, you are fired from Ukhozi. Oh my God, like really? she was, you know, these young people.
Yeah.
Oh really, you know, with my producer.
Yeah.
Do you think you can record same time, 6 o'clock in the morning until late?
Yes.
Mm. Also, instead of giving you an episode of 26, okay, I'm coming back.
But we're giving you 208 episodes. Hey, Bishop, hey.
Mm.
Yeah, man, Bishop, that day, that day, yeah.
Linda,
I'm fired together. Ngithola mom sebenzi. And ngahola, uNkulunkulu uzibona ukuthi unjani. uNkulunkulu, mina Bishop, I believe.
Yeah.
uNkulunkulu wanted to check ukuthi, do you believe ukuthi it's not over until I say it's over?
Yeah.
Ngiyakuxosha ngala, but ngifuna ukuphile. Ngokhe lingane esikoleni. Ngizokunika umholo times two, so uzophila. Banginike contract for 208 episodes. Wow. radical faith.
Radical faith, Linda. There was a time, people may not know, I went to your home, Eshowe. You have built a beautiful residence, built a beautiful house for your mom and for yourself. And once in a while, I learn and I read from the newspaper, all that has been bent down.
Yes, for sure.
All, you know, literally, all the work that you have done was banned. How did you survive a time like that?
Bishop,
what kept you going?
Mozo pega wuti is January, February, March, ngoshiwa ngiko kozini.
Yes.
March, April, May, and then Ivuma, young approach.
Right.
So before Mokale Vuma, and then there was a wildfire around. I'm recording a studio soon, Wazi, and I missed calls from Umang. But once in fucking makeup, let me just call her. Banjo Mshan, at your Malum, which Ugogutang, Jeruti, your house, Yash. You have a joke in California, go back and record. And then on break again, and come back, and then I call them and say, Mshan, are you serious? Well, no, you're young, he's in Shida, and he's in Shida, and my valley phone. Then my crew is 30, Bobby with 38, and then I call them and this pray, and guys, he's well into 12. But I tell them, my pastor, you have to be strong. Well, if I told them at 12, what was the Tangham? So I said to myself, okay, if Bazo Tangham, Monday is Wednesday, in doing it, Pindi Boy. Let's work.
Let's finish the course.
Tamam, I'm telling what guys, let's pray when my house is bent down. I'm following them, I'm be strong, I'm coming on the weekend. The weekend I went there. And so I called one Kanzela and I said, please, man, can you just get a TLP, remove this thing? Sure. I'm going to build another house. Then I left. I remember that one Monday when I was about to record. So because of stress and pressure on my, you don't even know Bishop Ngakufihlela as a friend and as a brother and as my bishop, as a dad in spirit. Ngangihamba to a studio. I saw outside kumnyama. But ngabuza ngapanga imoto ngabuza akunjani ngaphandle, but no it's kunelanga ngathi it's dark.
Sure.
So when I parked the car out of the studio and then I collapsed and then mabe figure, but I saw them mabe ngibiza ngathathwa ngasiwa one of the center lapha next to the studio. The doctor said, no, but how did you bring this guy here? Well, no, this guy is he's out.
Sure.
99% he can be ngaba with stroke now.
Wow.
This guy.
Wow.
But can you imagine bang faga we must something to a surgical, something like that? From there bang nigi pili is really strong and bang vuga as ulinda, you know. Not I wanna go and record, but I know. I was recording a student bambi kinda ganje, but we breaking yeah and kulum mang we breaking bambi ganje. I'm a casting abon because they were casting on one thing tabe corner we show.
Okay.
And then that's me. I mean I have a radical faith.
Linda, there's this element where I've seen you because, you know, I've been with this man. I've seen you in the stages of the ANC. And I know the person who's been very close to your heart is the former president, Jacob Zuma.
Yes.
I know. what made you have that love and that attraction to a man like Jacob Zuma?
Sure. I think people among a man who president, the former, he's my president even now, he's a father. Namalala is a father, president. There were moments, Abanda Bangazi, I'll sit, Mamu Yaga, he will leave me with the president when things were tough before he became a president.
Right.
But
right.
I must say something to him. Abanda Bayas don't. Do what? But say something to this man. And then he would just accompany Bugozake. And then I'll speak in Sengkandle when there was no tarot, we gravel. And then 11, 12, 1, 2, until 2 in the morning. Baba. That's one in excess. Then I'll leave. Go by the bond that I didn't. I'm tata as a politician. I'm tata as a mundo from a party, but I'm tata as a father. I'm not demanding about Matu Mabalala. He's a father.
He's a father.
Oh, Baba. He became a president of the country. Now, first thing he will just say to you, oh, absolutely. So I'm attracted, but the times where he will take us through a rope and island, I mean, I think in information for my kids, they know a lot. He will take me through rope and island. He will take me through about the former president, Teko Tabumbe. He will take me through about Madebe. He will take me through about Mlangeni. Babul Susuli, he'll take me through about the chess, take me through about the ball at a prison. He will take me through Engapanle. He will take me through going to Engali, where Jele, where Mapunea Funabuse, as a Kulum, or Babeka Mundusha, something is Zoo.
Right.
A brilliant man, a man who can read, a man who can think, a man who can come up with something. I'll tell you something, that's the first time, because you in my heart. One day there was a man who was not saying anything good about me, and then the president said to me, the former president, will you please go and fetch this man at the airport? And then among him airport, this guy was, he was saying things isn't echo right.
Yes.
He called my number and then he dropped my phone and then he called Mamo. He says, "Omi Mamu Taibo, the number Baba Ngenga is on the wrong."
Yeah, okay.
But you know, he's the right person. Yeah.
He's the right person.
Who first game I this guy, he kept quiet from airport to Tegwin until must figure show what I saw on the police.
My God.
Must figure out. Let me tell you the story. President, we sat down there. They're waiting for normal white men get it, but oh, I never get. Oh, I was in cool minutes. I'm at the insist on a temple.
Yes,
just a show. I'm going to be shaker. I'm going to be a man. Let me get the phone. What to Munda, Baba, no matter the number of Zuid. What I oh, Sabo, Baba, absolutely, Baba. So we are back. He wanted to finish that thing to that person. So he is very intelligent.
Yeah,
he's like. The only person ngangaba naye ngihambe SABC, it was you. Because I knew ukuthi uba in that table ye entertainer to have you there. With a smile looking at me. You saw me when I was at my weakest. But I knew ukuthi uzokhuluma noma yini uzokusho something ebhedayo ehlekisayo. Masingene umuntu enothike mguma sithi yaziduba vethi. Wele wenza lento yaba easy. So in times like that, you needed Muto Njengawe.
Yeah.
When I left Ukhozi, I went to the president. I don't know, the decision had been taken. Mm. And he was drinking and we were upon the juice. But how? What in the Mkuru? Oh, you were in Dota. In Dota was a pillar. Was a pillar. I said, go on, we'll pillar my elections. From there, and then seeing you there, things are in the Palilang from Ukuruma, Bole, I had to be very much strong,
no. It's amazing, you know, Linda. you are saying something about learning forgiveness. Let me put you in another spotlight. Recently, you were supposed to make an advert in Ukhozi. You are supposed to make an advert in Ukhozi, and all of a sudden, you know, Linda Sibuye is going to, and people, let me tell you, people are expecting because they know this advert is going to Ukhozi. Yeah. They are excited because Linda Sibuye Ukhozi, and all of a sudden, it's not closed. How did you feel and how did you treat that situation? Because, I mean, you are a human being.
I forgave them. But when you hear something from the top management, they know automatically, once you were on air, you have a data balalil.
Right.
They by resolve the thing, and then I went back for that advert in Yadalwa. And again, now I'm going back next week for Magic Broadcasting Academy. So, but now I was angry. Now I'm not the part. I am bringing money to the station. In Manjin Valley, Mali, over Imala Nayo, where we had, which is no money. But in Abakolang Uti, Bishop, the experience that I have is only me and not to call. Yes. That we have that experience.
Okay.
Even now, I was saying my boys, I said, you know what, even I don't want to even go back there, but I want to work with the station and then bring money and then be associated with the brand because what I am, I work in Mpumalanga, I work in Free State.
Yes.
It's because of this brand.
Yes.
But Uma Uti Bishop, even on my birthday, Abasagas Banja was the mezzo, no chatabara showing gun, but no, Tina will say it. OPK Bashoing gun.
They've learned from you.
Yeah, but no, we don't care. To go to the bank for a lava, but trust me, I mentioned over Abalai Basakfuna bank. So, about Basava Mokunikabala. So, but I forgave them because I think the decision that was taken by the former management, even that man, I forgave him. Even whatever dealings that he had, I forgive him because I think the pressure that they got from out there is that Mangi Kona in a room, in a meeting with the staff, Mangi Kona, he couldn't say things. Wow. And if I raise my hand, and get, no, the station has run Oganje.
Okay.
He had a problem. Because I know, even now, Bishop, if Poloza was still at Ukhozi, I will ngabang hambang, ngabang kona.
Wow.
He was not fearful because he was a radio presenter.
Okay.
He was a brand as well.
All right.
The
okay.
mistake is that it's like Bishop Vusdube, where the ECC. So whoever of guy, you don't have a problem. You say, oh, this boy,
then you groom him.
You groom that person.
Yeah, yeah.
And on a problem. The day of a rebellious, okay, but me, as a father, I'll always give that person a blessing. The former management, we're supposed to say, even if, let me say, I was wrong. Linda, you are wrong. as a station, we're going to suspend you. Because I was never suspended.
Yeah.
We'll suspend you for 3 months and go home, but come back, learn from your mistakes.
Yeah.
But my thing, it was now.
No. you know, I was there. I don't want to be too.
That's again, love. Yes.
Yeah. So, Linda, now you are talking to me. You talked in passing about Linda Spears Academy.
Yes.
You have learned so much in life. You've got a university experience in radio. You are a legend.
Yes, for sure.
I mean, you honestly have done something remarkable in this generation. Yes, and sure. Your name will never be forgotten. That's at true. Any given time. Now, you say you are talking about the academy. Shortly, what is happening with Linda Spears now?
Academy, I had a vision that one day I'll have my own academy. And Manji Kona, Magic Broadcasting Academy, it's a follow the TVET.
Okay.
We have about 50 students, and then in Durban we are launching again. We've got 120 students are coming. And I want to thank the Minister of Arts and Culture.
Okay.
We're partners.
Yes.
We're building a studio here in Durban, and then we're building a studio in Johannesburg. I've got an office in Johannesburg and Durban, and then Umfolozi. It's amazing. The MICT sector, I'm accredited. There's a company, who wanted to buy me. They were offering me something. I said, no, the experience that I have, a yummy, so that I can pass it on to the black child.
Generation.
Yeah, Steve Bigoti, black man, you're on your own. So I'm on my own here. Let me give these young people then an opportunity to become content producers, to become radio personalities. It's going very well. COVID is pazamisile, but the classes are Kubega and Polozi. Laetebwin is going to be private. Jobek is going to be private. Kimberley and Mafikeng, again, we getting the money from the MICT Center and then Arts and Culture. So I won't let you. God has been good, Bishop.
Wow.
But what helped me, Bishop?
Yes.
Over underground and avoid noise and be away. Tell Abandubazi, Bishop. If you're under attack and you're going to try some tribulations, try. Have time with God and be alone.
Let us be. You know, it's amazing. I feel like I can listen to you. I can, you know, I've been with you many times. Sally Hilton, Ukulume, Glalele, and I see a great vision in this young man. I see, you know, a great thing. Now, we are living in the days of COVID-19.
Yes, for sure.
People are hopeless. They are losing jobs.
Sure.
Men are failing to support their families. They need somebody who's going to speak life to them.
Yes,
and I believe that you are one of those people who could give life. I mean, the mere fact that you always say it is not over until God says it's over. That slogan has kept a lot of people afloat in their situation.
Yes, for sure.
I know people, one lady who comes to church here, Cindy, who has been in prison, who listened to you in prison. Aish. You brought that girl here in church. She's still here. She's struggling with the issues of life, but every time she keeps afloat because she says, every time Sklabana and Atu, Yakumbulgale told Linda Spears, so I'm obliged to go to Gimnagegele. You know, you have that slogan that says it's not over until God says it's over. People are in a dire need and dire situation because of COVID-19. What can you say to them to bring back hope into their lives?
I was telling one politician in Johannesburg, I said, it is not over until we defeat the COVID. This thing of COVID, everyone is scared, Bishop.
Yeah.
Everyone is scared.
Yeah.
You know, in businesses, entrepreneurs, when you meet people on the street, and then guys from the entertainment industry, AKA, were saying, things are bad. I don't have money because of the COVID. We're not getting any gigs. Musicians are they're crying. I get DMs from actors and say, Spia, things are tough.
Yeah.
I said to one guy, Ugisibai, I said, my brother, you don't have money right now. But as long as you're going to stick to the plan, Bishop, I'm one of the people this year. We started 1 week in follow the TV at the Magic Broadcasting Academy. And then COVID started. What are every survived?
Wow.
It means I will never send an invoice and get paid.
Mm.
I sat down with my team. I said, guys, I want to tell you something. I believe in you. You will not get paid.
Yeah.
Even if you get the God of your salary. Let me tell you something. We are here. We are here. Mm. But they stick to the plan. As long each and every human being, Lam Shabini, Anga, stick to the plan. The vision. Don't change your vision. Don't change your strategy. Follow your dream and say, I understand. Now we are better. Imoto, speak to the bank.
Yeah.
Speak to the bank about your bond and tell them, would give me 6 months. Don't run away from ama izinto zakho, like it's calling. Go to a school and say, Kuro, I'm here. I'm in trouble. Give us 6 months. Okay. Even if it means next year, may we tatinga nyam, you can even blacklist me. Have a strategy. But the mistake enzo abantu is to not to stick to the plan. I'm going to change for my shortcuts.
All right.
But okay, man, so I know, hey, academy, I hear that much. Let me go. I'm selling a mask. Everyone's selling a mask. Everyone's selling a mask.
Sanitizer. Sanitizers.
Stick to the plan. One guy said to me, Spear, I understand what I can stick to my plan, but now I'm not too much.
Okay. It's
me now, 2014, at the end of 2014, I called the bank. I said, bank, take this car. I'm not going to afford it.
Yeah.
There are things often we surrender.
Okay.
So that you can receive things.
Wow.
And two, Bishop, understand that the situation of your Jingaman. Call your family and say, lend me taller. 100%. This is about 30%.
Wow.
Then give me 10. This is about 2 centimeters. Because I can see his nose are bad. The mistake I'm a daughter in particular. I'll push upon them for 6 months. I can see you're powerful.
Okay.
My brother, can you push my car? Because I can see you're powerful.
Wow.
But this is what I'm waiting for. I'll come back to you. I'm an entrepreneur. Don't gossip on the entrepreneur. If you don't imagine. Because, Bishop, there was a time where I was waiting for 500,000. But I needed 1,000 rand in Joburg. I was stranded that night. But I had to be very strong.
Yeah.
That guy gave me 1,000 rand. But midnight, I'm saying, in the mud. And I had to go back to me and say, my brother, how come? It's because Bishop, see, but intimidated. Poverty, normally struggling. And more if you. And in poverty, the problem, the trial, it may ball, but at a game reserve, Uma Ipubes border, normally Zagwena, Umachi Ubale.
All right,
Yima Ube,
Faisanana. Okay,
so Ishonai, a problem on Nayo, Yamu Ube, would know, but when I'm king, Gila. Guys, come on. You cannot let me down. I'm waiting for money. It's poverty. Things are bad. It's coronavirus. But I cannot let my kids and my family into a problem. So face that problem on I.
So we are closing now. I tell you, we could go on and on because I had a lot of things that I was still going to ask you. But we'll get another time to finish up this, because I wanted to address the issue where we are going to confront the government. If, as Ulinda Sibiya was given an opportunity to speak to the president, to speak to the premier, and plead for the young people, for the young generation at this time, what would you say to the president? President, this is the time. Maybe you are not going to speak much about corruption that is happening now, of which I am going to say from this seat sitting here. Anybody who does corruption with the 500 billion that the government has given out to assist the people, anybody who does a corruption on the PPE issues that the government has been assigned to the people, that person must be arrested. It doesn't matter who. If anybody will swindle ama tenders, lawa ayiswe ekoleni ukuthi go clean ikole kulungiswe nokudla kweingane zesikole, anybody who does that and in the name of an organization that is leading, that person must be arrested.
Sure.
Must be arrested, whether it is the high person in the office of the president or any person low who is sweeping the floors of the president. If it was president himself, he would be arrested, because we wanted the government to be in the hands of the people. But if you are given an opportunity, Linda, to speak to the government, to speak to the premier, and plead for the young people, what would you say today? Next week, I will tell you, I'm inviting another young lady.
Yes, come on.
Uchesita Ngobese. She has been saying things.
Open about things.
Open about things.
She's not brave.
People. issues about government, how we as government officials are doing to these young ladies. She's here sure. next week. Yeah, yeah. We are going to talk
sure.
hot issues. But I do want you to to say something to the government on behalf of the young people. You know their plight, you know their sure. cries every day. And then I want you to close, obviously, with any statement of faith that says to the young people, be hopeful, it's not over until God says it's over. Up to you.
To the president, if the opportunity in Itola, one, be in touch with the people.
Yes.
Where's the youth from at? Be in touch with them. Have a Zoom meeting of 100 of them. And then they can even select my representatives as of a corner. We at. Music can be dance, it can be acting. Please be in touch. If you go to USA, AUS president, Yaziwangi at, or Beyonce, Jay-Z, acting Yaziwangi at. If you run away from them, you are making a huge mistake. To any premier, any province, be in touch with the youth. Mm. And number two, make sure premier have Imbizo on online for unemployed graduates.
Wow.
Unemployed graduates. They are crying. Banama degrees, banama diplomas. They have all the qualifications, but they just want an opportunity. So if as a premier and the cabinet or MECs in each and every province, you don't have time to sit down and say, sibasiza kanjani abantu basha abagraduatile abasemakhaya, lawo abantu abasha bazoba a problem to the country because bayile university and then they've been to TVET colleges. But be in touch with them. Number three, you promise the 350, give it to the people. Banigezeni abantu 350. Number four, arts and culture minister Nathi Mthethwa, people we arts that are waiting, when are they getting a relief fund? Noma kwenzakalani, try. Five, the last one, economic development. Any province, MECs, and also the minister of economic development, make sure you look into it. Abantu bahlaba abahamba ama wheelchairs, ama crashes, and then women in particular. And noma kunjalo, look at young men out there. When I was doing the interview, we spoon was 9 million fatherless, although bekhona 9 million fatherless boys who are crying out there. Please try, as you are giving the opportunity abantu besifazane, but lama daughter la yonke lento enzakalayo, please bear in mind ukuthi uningabi kude. I think president, you are far away from the people of South Africa. Come closer. The speeches and everything on television that you sometimes you go there for 1 hour, we don't need that. Now it's time you sit with your cabinet and tell them, the Minister of Communications, now call my people. I want the youth of South Africa to speak. And definitely, more than that, you'll see abantu abasha bazothini kwena.
Wow. So, Tobe, that is powerful.
Thanks.
That is very powerful, so, Tobe, especially at this time to make the government, because we do get abantu abafana now who can still speak sense to us. You know, during COVID-19, there is a serious confusion.
Yes.
You know, any videos and people are saying, here is hope.
Yes.
Here is hope. It's a time of confusion. But mhlambe isikhathi njengoba uSotobe show asibeke phansi emoya.
We
understand ukuthi COVID-19 ikhona, but there is still life. Remember that after COVID-19, we still have life.
Yes, sir.
You are not a seed that is going to die during COVID-19. David says, I am not going to die, but I'm going to live so that I can testify about the goodness of the Lord in the land of the living. So, which says to me, you are not going to die. You know, what is more important? You must have your mask at all times. That is very important. Let us have our mask at all times. Listen to me, we have to defend ourselves.
Sure.
Number two, we need to sanitize all the time. Let us use a sanitizer.
Yes.
Number three, let's wash our hands and try as much to keep a social distance all the time.
Yeah.
And I believe ukuthi uma senze njalo uNkulunkulu uzosigcina. So Tobe, I want to thank you very much for being part of my seat, hot seat today.
We did not go as deep.
There are things, you know, when we come back in at a certain point, I'm going to bring Usotobe back. I'm going to bring him back, especially when we discuss the cultural month, when it comes to izinto zabantu abasha and arts. Ngifuna be a spokesperson wabantu be art when we begin in September. So I'm going to bring him back and then dig him from the bottom. You know, I glided on top now. I've been with this man in Venda, you know, for distance, you know, we've spent time with him, and I really appreciate that he has been standing all the time. I believe that faith in him has made him stand. Even though he could not believe sometimes that uNkulunkulu is sustaining him up to this far. God has sustained you, Sotobe.
That's true.
And I want to thank you, and I want to encourage you to continue with faith that you have. I've put you in on a stage, and you have ministered. There are times when I said to Sotobe, say something to these people for 3 minutes. But Sotobe will speak the word of God to these people that I feel like, no, I don't have to preach. I must sit down and relax. And I think God has great things on your future. Stand strong, Sotobe. Unkulunkulu uyakuthanda. Sisazoba nawe futhi in the near future. Thank you for respecting us today. Bazalwane, bafwethu, bodadewethu, nibe nesikhathi esimnandi emakhaya. Take care of yourselves. If singeke isizathu sokuthi uhambe ekhaya,
hlale ekhaya.
That is the safest thing that can happen to you. God bless you. We love you.
Thank you. God bless you, Bishop. Thank you so much. I play boxing as well, so because of you.
I cannot even speak about that. And it was one of those things that I've seen so far. As you can see, he has lost so much weight.
Yeah.
No mum kaba.
I know, Bishop. No, you don't.
I love that challenge.
Yeah.
Thank you so much. God bless you. Bishop. Thank you.
But our souls have found an escape. A hiding place in you. The fowler snare is broken. Our help is in the name of the Lord. No, nothing without you. Without you. You are.
Hosanna to Jehovah. You are the air that I breathe. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. And you nothing without you, without you. You are the air that I breathe. Can't live without you, can't live without you. And you are live and move and have my being. We say Hosanna to Jehovah. You are the air that I breathe. Hallelujah. 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 Yeah. Hosanna. Hallelujah, hallelujah, and you.